everyone. Ready to jump into the crazy world of online dating. Today we're going to be talking about what happens when things get a little too intense, a little too fast.
Yeah.
Like, you know, when you can't tell if you found the love of your life or if you're about to end up on a dating horror story.
Yeah, oh, I know exactly what you mean.
Right. So to help us unpack all of this, we're diving into a blog post by John McElhenney.
Okay.
He calls himself a life coach, and the post is titled, "The Hot Heat Test. Dating 2.0, Bring the Heat."
Bring the heat, huh?
That's right. And boy, does he.
Sounds intense.
It is. First things first. Anyone else feel like online dating is like this crazy, unpredictable whirlwind? Like, you go from a flood of messages to a total drought in like 5 seconds.
Yeah, finding a real connection online.
It can be tough.
It's definitely a challenge. It's like all that back and forth can really speed things up.
Yeah.
It creates this like instant intensity that you just don't get in person.
Exactly. And McElhenney actually says, get this, that 90% of those super intense connections are, quote, bullshit.
Wow. He doesn't hold back.
Nope. He even says that usually one person is, quote, insane, or they just want completely different things.
Okay, yeah, I can see that. Huh. It's easy to get caught up in the excitement, right?
Yeah, boy.
But online, you're only getting a tiny glimpse of someone, even with all the photos and those, like, super polished bios.
Oh, for sure. You end up projecting what you want to see onto someone.
Yeah, and then bam, suddenly you're, like, swept away in this fantasy before you even know who they really are.
That's why McElhenney is all about recognizing those red flags, right?
Makes sense.
He has this whole 9-step program for finding love.
9 steps.
Yeah, and red flags are like the biggest thing he talks about.
Like what?
We're talking weird behavior that comes out of nowhere.
Right.
Confessions that sound too good to be true. You know, the kind of stuff that makes your gut scream run.
Oh yeah, we've all been there. Have you ever had any red flag moments like that? I bet. What did you do? Did you listen to that inner voice or just, like, ignore it?
I think we've all been guilty of ignoring it at some point.
Totally. It's so easy to get swept up in the moment, especially when you feel like you're connecting with someone.
Oh, yeah. You start thinking, maybe this is different.
Right. But McElhenney makes this interesting point about super connected relationships versus super heated ones.
Oh, yeah. What does he say about that?
He actually thinks that those super heated connections, the ones that, like, explode with passion really quickly, well, he thinks they're often more about unresolved issues than real love.
Whoa, that's deep.
Right. Like all that instant, intense chemistry and that feeling of like, oh my God, we're soulmates. He's saying it can sometimes be a sign to slow down and like look inward a little bit.
Interesting.
He even talks about using something called Hendrix data to figure out your own patterns and see if you're repeating like unhealthy stuff from your past.
Hendrix data. I'm not sure what that is.
Me neither. He didn't really explain it, but it definitely makes you think.
Oh, yeah. Speaking of things that make you think, McElhenney tells the story about a woman he met online.
Okay, what happened?
He describes her as, like, self-immolating.
Huh.
Yeah, basically she was super intense at first, you know, all over him.
Right, right.
And then, poof, gone.
Just like that?
Yep. No explanation, nothing.
That's rough.
It is. And it really made me wonder if this whole disappearing act is, like, a common thing in online dating.
I mean, it wouldn't surprise me.
Right. You're dealing with so many different people online.
Exactly.
Different personalities, different levels of emotional maturity.
Totally. Not everyone is ready to handle the ups and downs of a relationship.
Especially not at warp speed, which is how it feels sometimes online.
It's like everything is on fast forward.
Exactly. And get this. When things like that happen,
yeah,
McElhenney says no contact, like cut them off completely.
Whoa, that seems a bit extreme.
It does.
But I guess sometimes you have to do what you have to do to protect yourself.
Yeah, create some space. The thing that really struck me, though, is McElhenney's idea that these crazy intense connections are often rooted in, like, past trauma.
Ooh.
I know, right? Deep stuff for a dating blog post.
Yes.
But it makes you wonder, doesn't it? Mm. Like, are we subconsciously drawn to the same kinds of relationships, even if they haven't been good for us before?
That's a good question.
Maybe those patterns, the ones we keep repeating, are trying to tell us something.
Like a warning sign or something.
Yeah.
Interesting.
So maybe it's not just about being careful about other people's red flags,
mm,
but also about recognizing our own.
Our own red flags. You mean like the things that make us jump into things too quickly?
Exactly.
That's really interesting.
Right. What are the things that make us go from 0 to 60 in like 2 seconds flat?
Hmm. Like that.
So maybe McElhenney isn't just giving dating advice. Maybe he's giving us like life advice.
Yeah, like a deeper way to understand ourselves.
Right. how our past experiences shape the choices we make today, even in our love lives.
Okay, I'm definitely intrigued.
Me too. And you know what? McElhenney has a lot more to say about all of this.
Oh, I bet he does.
But that's for next time.
Okay, I can't wait.
Stay tuned.
It's like, we almost need like a new way to understand our feelings online.
Yeah, especially when it comes to dating.
It's so easy to get lost in all the excitement.
Right, so I think what I'm hearing from McElhenney is that it's all about being aware of how intense things can get.
Yeah.
It's not about running away, but maybe just like taking a minute to step back.
Okay, yeah.
And figuring out what's really going on.
So instead of jumping into something too fast,
yeah,
or making like big decisions when you're still caught up in the moment,
right,
he's saying we should use those first sparks as a chance to really look at ourselves.
He talks about cooling off when things get too heated.
Oh, interesting.
I wonder what he means by that.
Like, do you think he means actually, like, stopping talking to the person?
Maybe.
Or is it more about just, like, shifting your mindset?
I think it could be both.
Right. Like, recognizing that those crazy, intense feelings, they might be fun, but...
they could be clouding your judgment.
Yeah. I know he's really big on running away at the first sign of a red flag.
Yeah. But doesn't that seem a little risky?
Risky how?
Like, what if you're being too careful? What if you miss out on something amazing?
That's a good point.
Where's the line between protecting yourself,
right,
and being open to something new?
You know, I think what McElhenney is saying is it's okay to put yourself first. Even if it means walking away from something that might not be good for you.
You know, it's funny, McElhenney's story about that woman who just disappeared.
Yeah, the self-immolating woman.
Right. It really made me wonder, how often does that actually happen in online dating?
Oh, I'm sure it happens more than we think.
You're dealing with all kinds of people online and...
not everyone knows how to handle, like, real relationships.
It's almost like some people can't deal with all the emotions.
And then they just, like, shut down.
And in those cases, McElhenney says... no contact is the only way to go.
It does make sense though, doesn't it?
Like to protect yourself from getting hurt even more.
Yeah. Sometimes you just need to step away from the situation.
One thing that really stuck with me was this idea that those super intense connections...
yeah.
He thinks they're often connected to something deeper.
Deeper how?
Like unresolved issues from the past. Trauma even.
Wow. It's like, sometimes we're drawn to the same kind of relationships over and over again.
Yeah, even if they weren't good for us.
And we don't even realize we're doing it.
It's like those patterns are trying to tell us something.
Like, pay attention.
Exactly. And maybe it's not just about looking for red flags in other people,
right,
but also in ourselves.
Like, what are the things that make us jump in too fast?
Exactly.
I don't like that.
So maybe McElhenney's advice isn't just about dating.
Yeah.
Maybe it's about a much bigger picture.
Like understanding ourselves better.
Yeah, like how the things that happened to us in the past affect our choices today, even in our love lives.
Okay, that's a really interesting way to think about it.
And you know what's funny?
Why?
We're always talking about other people's red flags, but
yeah.
McElhenney made me think about my own red flags.
Oh, like the things that make you go a little crazy for someone.
Exactly.
Makes you wonder, doesn't it?
Yeah. What are the things that make us get swept up too quickly?
Yeah. And how can we learn from those patterns?
Right. It's like maybe that's the real key to figuring out this whole online dating thing.
Maybe it's not just about being careful or looking for warning signs.
Yeah.
Maybe it's about taking a good hard look at ourselves.
And what we really want in a relationship.
Okay. I'm starting to see what you mean.
It's like figuring out our own personal Hendrix data.
Right. Whatever that is.
Exactly.
I think McElhenney's definitely onto something here.
Yeah.
Even if his advice can be a little... well, extreme sometimes.
It's definitely making us think.
It is.
And isn't that what a good deep dive is all about?
You got it.
It's like he wants us to be more intentional, right? Not just swiping and hoping for the best.
Totally. Like, take some time to figure out who you are, you know, what you really want.
Yeah. And it's funny, he keeps mentioning this Hendrix data thing.
I know.
I still don't know what that means, but...
me neither. But it sounds like...
it makes you think about patterns, right?
Yeah, like maybe there are these themes in our relationships.
Right. Like, are we always falling for the same kind of person, even when it hasn't worked out before?
Yeah. Maybe those patterns are our own Hendrix data.
Right. Like, clues about what we need to change.
Okay, I like that. It's like, instead of just focusing on the other person, we need to look at ourselves too.
And not just in a like love yourself kind of way.
Right. More like, hey, what are my red flags?
Exactly. Like, what are the things that make me fall for someone too quickly? What makes me ignore the warning signs?
Okay. Yeah. Mm-hmm. That's really smart.
So it's almost like this advice isn't just about dating. It's about being more self-aware in general.
Right. Like how our past experiences, good and bad, shape our choices.
Even in our love lives.
Totally.
So I guess the big question is, how do we actually use all of this in our dating lives?
Yeah, it feels like it goes beyond just like being careful or looking for red flags.
Yeah.
It's more about really understanding who you are and what you want.
And knowing how to protect yourself.
Right. I think that's what McElhenney's getting at, even if he's, you know,
a little intense sometimes.
Yeah. But...